Hello, this is Sean with Blade Mate Lawn Care. I believe what I have today is the biggest cleanup job that I have ever undertaken. I'm definitely not going to get it done in this video. This is going to be a multiple part job. Yeah, so the gentleman who lives here, he's an elderly chap, he's around 80 years old. You know, it's not an uncommon story. You get older and you know, you struggle to keep up with this sort of work. He's lived here his entire life. So to anyone who says, well, if you can't bloody maintain your place, you should get out, you know, try telling that to someone who's lived in a house for 80 years. It's not going to happen, and I respect that. And so I'm here today to give him a hand. Anyway, guys, I'll show you around. Let's go. This is down the side of the house. I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, sure, I've seen you do worse than this before. Well, you haven't seen the backyard yet. So as you can see, the front yard is not the worst. There has been another gent, another older fella that I've met. His name's Les, lovely old fella. He's been here trying to do what he can. So I've been in touch with him, and yeah, just tried to organise time to come out, and here I am. This is the other side of the house. I've got my clogger shin pads on. They also double as snake bite protectors, since it is spring now and they will be in here somewhere. That's the front and the sides that I've just shown you so far. Here's a sneak peek at the back. There's actually a shed in behind there. There is a structure, look. And this stuff's called lantana. It's a very spiky thing. Very, very much an irritant to your skin. Now I've spoken to the gent who lives here and discussed that I'm just gonna chop it all. And that it includes that. I'm gonna go through there as well. Told you it was a big one. Ask me if I'm nervous walking through here. Bloody snakes. Yep, that's huge. So this is the fence line. That's actually the neighbor's yard over there. That lantana's well above my head. I walk up to it. The camera is currently at my eye level, and I'm 6'2", so you can kind of work out how tall all that stuff is. Huge. And none of this is meant to be here, none of it. See if we can't find the shed through here. Oh, there's sheet metal there on the ground. Snakes love hiding under that. So for occasions such as this, where I don't really know where to start, you just pick a spot. In this case, I'm going to start at the front, at the road, and work my way that away. Ha ha ha. I'm just going to stop here for now, for this side of the house. Like I said, it's good to have a plan of how I'm going to attack it, so I've decided I'm just going to hold it kind of here at the corner to there, and everything, you know, kind of forward of the house. That's what I'm going to try and achieve today. Oh.
Thank you.
So here's today's job down this side of the house. You can literally see the line on the ground where I finished yesterday. So my goal yesterday was to get basically everything forward of the house, which I achieved. So yeah, these two strips go all the way down there, and you can't see it, but behind that shrubbery all the way at the end there's a shed. So we're going to try and reach the shed today. This should be fun. Let's go. Yeah.
Now, just before I do my first tip run, just going to take care of something that I missed yesterday, and that's just pruning this tree back just a little bit. Yeah, just obviously kind of obstructs any car that tries to back in here.
Thank you.
Did I mention that this is the first time in I don't know how many years there's been a car in this driveway? Good progress. Let's see if we can go for a walk through here without getting smashed by a snake. In case anyone's wondering, we have eastern brown snakes and red-bellied black snakes feature quite prominently in this area. And it's springtime, so it's coming into the breeding season and they love hanging out in this sort of terrain. Oh wow, I didn't quite realize that was there when I did my first walk around. It's big. Oof. Okay, well I guess we'll start in this side of the house, see how we go.
Oh.
Time to load all this up and go for my second tip run of the day. So the biggest challenge I'm facing with this job, it's not cutting it out, it's not even dragging it out, it's collecting it all and disposing of it. There's just so much green waste to remove. Yeah, so a good exercise anyway. Bloody, we're in lockdown at the moment, I'm allowed to work obviously, but unfortunately I haven't been able to hit the gym, so I've been relying on my work to get my exercise in, and needless to say, I think I'm getting an okay workout with this one today. Might just spend a little bit of time kind of beautifying it. I've only got a little saw, so I can't really chop it off there. Well, I could, but I'll be here all day, so I'm just gonna cut off these gnarly looking bits. And likewise down there on that one. A little bit puffed. You can kind of see the piles blending in. The biggest challenge that these vines present is that they go everywhere. Like, there'll be parts in this pile that finish over there, and you don't realize that until you have them all in your hands, picking them up, trying to stuff them into the bag, but they got a snag on something, so you kind of find yourself getting nowhere. Look, it's part of the fun. We'll get there. Thank you. And we'll see if we can't even maybe expose part of the carport that's hidden under there. More often asked, what are the stranger things that I find when I clear this stuff out? Well, what do we have under here? It's like a pile of bricks. Looks like an old bloody foundation, and that looks like an old freezer. Yeah, fun. Well, that's ironic.
Oh,
hosing all that off was less for aesthetics and more for safety for the old boy. I don't want him walking out here and slipping on that kind of, you know, quarter inch layer of mud that was there. Yeah. Anyway, still looks much better even with the hose, so that's good. I had no idea that was there. Could you guys tell? Before I finish up, I'm just gonna track a path around the clothesline so the old boy can get out there and use it. We're going to try and get to the front of the shed, so the back of the carport. Just imagine a line on the ground. That's kind of how I'm doing this cleanup, just segmenting it one part at a time. Yeah, alrighty, so let's get started on today's adventure. pretty familiar by now with all these vines that have been battling the whole time, and I believe we've found the source. So if you look closely in here, this is kind of wire set up with some hanging wire as well, just here where I have my finger, you can kind of see it, but these little bits are everywhere along here. So my theory is that a long time ago, this is where it all originated, perhaps to maybe add almost like a natural wall here on the side of this carport, which I guess is a good idea, but you know, here we are however many decades later, and these vines have gone all the way under the foundations of the house, have worked their way up into the weatherboards on the side, and you know, popping off window frames and all that sort of stuff. So yeah, pretty invasive stuff.
Thank you.
And here's all we have left. Looks like a pretty big job, but when you look at how far we've come, all the way down there and to the front, as you saw, it's really not a great deal of work remaining comparatively.
Yeah.
Well, the easy part's over.
Everything I've done so far was really just to give me access to, you know, the main part of the job itself, which is the lantana. Check this out. Been a few suggestions, people saying, why don't you get yourself a brush hog or a slasher or something like that. I've used some pretty good ones in my time. They can't go through that. I'm gonna call it right there. That's not gonna happen. The only way to get that out is to either burn it, which you can't do in the middle of bloody suburbia, or the hard way, which is exactly what I'm gonna have to do. Okay, well, we've made quite a bit of progress. This is all cleared out. Now, as you can see, I revealed the edge of the garden there, so that's why I didn't go too crazy trying to get all the sticks out, because it's getting like mulch in here anyway. Anyway, we've got a bit of rain starting, so I'm gonna have to finish up for the day. And that line that you see across my camera, that's actually a crack. So I'm gonna get a new bloody GoPro too. Oh well.
Righto, so I've taken probably a third of it, maybe half. There is still a fair bit to go. I've gone through it with the chainsaw and chopped it up, not that you can really tell, but it is in smaller bits, so it should hopefully be a bit easier to move. This area here on the ground, that's a bit greener. You can tell that's where most of it was. Our trailer's overflowing, that's all right. See if I can come back through the week or come back and help Sean out next time. He's here. We'll see how we go. Hopefully that helps at least. Righto, thanks.
Decent amount of green waste to get rid of, so I'm finally going to do it because it's actually practical to do so today. Look what I brought. Let me just show you something to put your mind at ease, because I've had comments on previous videos when I use this thing, people are concerned about me putting my hands down, so I can't even reach where the blades are. Like, I'm full arm extension, and there's still about 10 centimeters between my fingertips and blade. So you kind of see me with my hands about here. And rest assured, I'm still nowhere near the blade. There's probably another foot. And this is about as far in as my arms ever go. So I've been hanging off that chipper for about 5 hours now. Got most of it, but there's a few big bits that can't fit. So I'm just gonna load everything up that's remaining and do a tip run. Well, ladies and gents, there's only so many hours in a day, or a week for that matter, and this is the third day that I've been back here just trying to do this part, and I've decided to call it. Not perfect, obviously. You know, there's still sticks on the ground, there's bits of sheet metal sticking up and you know, that sort of stuff. You know, I didn't get in there. A lot of the stuff that's kind of hidden underground, like this sheet metal, that will start to reappear after a little bit of time, and all this debris on top will decompose. Now the client does have a friend who comes and helps, but he's more than capable of, you know, providing upkeep moving forward. And like I said, I could be here for weeks and months, you know, getting all the everything out of there and getting every last vine off the roof and all that sort of stuff. But you know what? I'm pretty happy with the job I've done, which, you know, gave this bloke his yard back and safe access to the shed. So just to close the loop on a couple of questions that no doubt people have. Also, that's wheelbarrow number 5 in case anyone was counting. The bricks and, you know, piles of sheet metal and all the crap under the carport, I was asked not to remove any of that. So that's why I'm not cleaning it up, because that fella I was talking about, the client's mate, he has plans to use that for some sort of construction stuff in the garage or something. I don't know, he didn't elaborate too much, but he just asked that I don't take it. That's why I didn't get a big skip in and dispose of it all. So, you know, just in case anyone was curious about why I've kind of left it the way I have. Well, the whole time I was doing this cleanup, I at no point ever felt like I was alone. And I feel like I've had all you guys, the viewers, keeping an eye on me the whole time I've been here working. And yeah, so I hope you're satisfied with the job I've done.